Welcome to EcoSummit TV. This is Jan, Michael Hess, you can call me Jan, and this is our guest, our friend Harry Böhme, CFO, Chief Financial Officer of Novalet, a leading OLED company based in Dresden. We have come all the way today from Berlin to Dresden, and we are going to shoot a very nice presentation we get now.
Just some facts about Novalet, founded in 2001 by Professor Leo and others, a spin-off of Fraunhofer Society and the TU Dresden, with the goal to commercialize OLED technologies, which were where aspects were developed in the TU Dresden. In 2010, we had 11.2 million in revenues, a growth of 30% year by year over the last years. We're completely venture capital financed, had a third round of financing, a third and last round of financing as we see it in 2009. In terms of IP, we have more than 400 patents in the field where we say this is the largest number of patents in this molecular doping field. 100 people, mainly working in Dresden. We have a presence in Taiwan, in Korea, and we have an office in Japan. Here we are coming to the techniques, basically to the basics of an OLED. As you can see here, an OLED consists of various layers of materials. You have two transport layers which transport electrons and holes. They meet in the emitting layer, and by this so-called recombination, they emit light. That's the basic structure of an OLED. You have it shown here in a little bit more detail. Novalet is, in its focus, working on the doping of these transport layers to make these transport layers very efficient and allow a very efficient traveling of electrons and holes through the transport layers, and by that, again, create a long-living and very efficient OLED.
Now we are in the chemical lab of Novalet, and I'm standing together with Mike Zöllner. He's a PhD in chemistry, and he's a project leader here in the chemistry lab of Novalet. And now, Mike, I would like to know, what exactly are you doing here, and why is it important for the total technology of Novalet?
Here, this is the place where we put our ideas, which we generate in our offices, into reality. So what we're going here is synthesizing molecules, we make analysis, and then we give it to our business lines, technology and business line engineering. Mm-hmm. Here's one typical reaction. You have got a flask, and this is heated a little bit, and hopefully our product forms. And mm-hmm. here, this is a very yellow one, and this is quite typical for OLED chemistry, that we have got colored materials. Mm-hmm.
So now we look funky, we wear glasses because we are in the lab, and it's a duty, it's a safety measure.
Security.
Security measure. And now Mike is going to explain to us what is actually happening with the molecules, because he cannot say what the molecules consist of, because this is the secret. So he will only explain how the molecules are transferred and transmitted by heating them up
right
to the surface where they actually are supposed to fulfill their function, in that case, generating light. So he's making a little scribble for us.
Right. So we have got functional materials. This means we've got hole transporters, electron transporters. Of course, you have got light-emitting molecules. And these materials are processed in a vacuum chamber. This means we have got a high vacuum. And in this vacuum, you have got a crucible which is filled with material. Mm-hmm. And over this crucible is a substrate, mm-hmm. mainly a glass substrate. Mm-hmm. And when you heat up this material, this evaporates and it condenses on the substrate. Mm-hmm. So then you have got your first layer, mm-hmm. which is maybe a hole transporting layer. Mm-hmm. After adding this hole transporting layer, you can add maybe a light emitting layer. Mm-hmm. After this, an electron transporting layer. Mm-hmm. So you can have separated layers with different functionalities. And when applying a voltage, your OLED starts to light. And what is really cool is that these layers are just about some nanometer thick. This means you can have very, very thin devices. You can make transparent displays, transparent lightning. You can make flexible things. And this is totally new. The properties which only OLEDs can offer you. No normal LED will this.
But at least we are not producing our commercial materials. The production is subcontracted, former to CIBA, now to BASF. So we license our IP, we sell our material, and we start our product with a completely fabless approach.
Can you explain why you are a fabless high-tech company and you decided not to create your own production facilities, create your own factory of the future?
Basically, if we look at the two parts of our business, one part is licensing of technology. Mm-hmm. Here the answer is clear. Mm-hmm. The other part is production of chemical materials. Mm-hmm. And this is a quite capital-intensive business. You have to set up a huge plant for this. The good thing is there are a lot of companies, especially so-called specialty chemicals companies like CIBA was in the past, who are doing it. So as a venture capital funded company who wants to build a business around that, it does not really make sense to do all the production facility yourself, but better to have this production subcontracted to a specialty chemicals company. We succeeded in developing really outstanding materials, but we also succeeded to get this into the production of one of the big players in the display industry. And all of that with a, let's say, quite limited amount of funding over the last 8 years. We are basically acting in a limited number of fields. We are acting in the display industry, which is a kind of simple equation. You have a defined product, which is a flat panel display. You have a defined number of players there, which are currently the LCD makers, who will start a mass production in OLEDs. You have the lighting field, which, frankly speaking, will be revolutionized by OLED. Why? I will come to that, but it will definitely change the value chain in lighting and will generate completely new players. You have the organic photovoltaic business, companies like Heliatech are in this business, and you have the other organic electronics, which is basically the printed electronics like RFID and other things.
So, do you also see startup opportunities for new companies who go into the business building luminaires, new customers for your technologies who think, look, this is so cool, we are great designers, we have so many ideas, we can create a new brand and just buy this technology from Novalet?
I think there are many opportunities currently, as the field is not so crowded. But the big challenge and the big problem also in terms of cost will be there is no standard. You have basically a standard for light bulbs, you also have one for LEDs, let's say, but you don't have a standard for contacting OLEDs, for the question how big should the light source be. You don't have any standards there, and therefore the company who wants to be successful in the business must also be able to set standards. Mm-hmm. And that certainly is a costly effort, mm-hmm. I would assume. There are some challenges to overcome, starting from explaining to people what an OLED light source basically means and for what it can be used. The value chain shift between the pure light source and the design is certainly one aspect, and the challenge really is to build a OLED lighting industry out of the OLED capabilities and the quite mature lighting industry. we as Novalet are certainly well positioned there. We are a cornerstone of nearly every European program dealing with the development of OLED for lighting. And we are currently pioneering the commercialization of OLED luminaires by building prototypes and end user products ourselves. So the conclusion, we address two multi-billion dollar growing markets, the display market, which is still a hugely growing market. You will have hundreds of millions of TV to be replaced in China in the next 5 years, let's say. And the lighting market, we're the leader in energy saving by using our technology. We have a unique skill set. We know about the OLED stack, we know about the material, and we have engineering capabilities. We have a close relationship with all major display makers, and we are currently pioneering the OLED lighting industry. So after 7 years of investment in technology and material, we are now starting to surf on the OLED mass production takeoff.
Is Novalet already selling to big display makers? Are you already inside one of the new OLED flat panel displays we can see in the market, or would that be the future generations?
We are currently selling into the production of one display manufacturer in Asia. We have confidentiality agreements here, so I cannot name it.
Many display makers really want to go into the green economy and position as a green product maker. So the energy saving part of building big screens, big displays, becomes a very important marketing factor. So I assume that they are really running after you, although you mentioned you have one deal in the pipeline, but the potential is really, really big because the consumers are increasingly buying green, or at least they want to buy green. For example, our new Sharp display, we actually selected because it's consuming the lowest number of watts per hour. Mm.
When you say, as you only have one deal in the pipeline, this is true and not true. The only sounds a little bit difficult. The point is, there is only one company actually producing OLED displays for mass production, and we have this one company as a customer. So you're true, okay. You're right. We only have one customer, but there is only one company outside. But you are also right.
We have the right customer.
We have the right customer. But you are also right. Basically, all the display makers, we are in contact with all the display makers on exactly that topic. And what they see as the Novalet advantage is, first of all, power efficiency. Power efficiency coming from the OLED as the medium itself, but enhanced power efficiency of an OLED which uses Novalet material and Novalet technology. OLED will not replace LCD. OLED will gain a bigger market share in the overall flat panel display market, where we assume that LCD will still dominate the flat panel display market. But even with that, the flat panel display market itself is an extremely growing market. So the, let's say, 20% market share of OLED in flat panel display in 5 years is far beyond what you have today.
You mentioned that you are doing your own prototypes. And what is the reason? Is it because nobody knows how to imagine a kind of OLED-powered luminaire future? And I would also say it's a kind of forward integration, right? In German, you would say, I think, Vorwärtsintegration. Yep. You go one step further to the customer in the value chain because nobody is fit enough, smart enough to innovate on their own without your
Basically, the reason why we did it is the following. When we talk about OLED for lighting, over the last years, we worked with a lot of players in these fields. So therefore, we also ourselves gained a lot of know-how, not only about the OLED, but also about other aspects of a luminaire, let's say. Point one. Point two, currently there are no OLED luminaires out there, at least last year that was the case. And we said, look, why not show what is capable in the lighting business with an OLED luminaire.